Hello, everybody, and welcome to Exercise 10-7. This is about the capitalization of interest. So just as kind of a brief recap, we're going to, when it comes to capitalizing interest, is that if we are self-constructing assets, meaning that we are building them on their own, part of the building of our own assets is that we're going to be taking out debt in order to construct a building. Whether we take out that debt or whether we not take out that debt, what we have to be aware of is the interest that relates to the debt while we are undergoing construction. Some of that debt may need to be, instead of recording interest expense, what we may need to do is capitalize the interest. And so what we're going to do is we're going to capitalize the lesser of the actual interest or the avoidable interest. Okay. So when it comes to the actual interest, we have three different loans. So over here, we have the construction short-term loan, and then we have the long-term loan. The loan amounts were $2 million, $1.4 million, and then $1 million. So my actual interest rate, this was at 12%, this was at 10, and this is at 11%. So my total interest is going to be 240, 140,000 and 110,000, or a total of 490,000. But I also have to compare this to the avoidable interest. What exactly is the avoidable interest? Well, it's going to be my weighted average of accumulated construction expenditures. So the way I'm going to compute the weighted average of accumulated expenditures, and here it actually gives it to me. So our weighted average accumulated construction expenditures were 3.6 million. Now, in terms of how I go through and determine what interest rate to apply to this, I'm going to break it down into two tiers. The first thing I'm going to go through and do is that if I have any loan that is construction specific, I'm going to address that first. So here we have a loan amount of $2 million that was taken out for the construction. So that is going to be one part of this. So my weighted average accumulated expenditures were 3.6 million. 2 million of this was a construction specific loan. So what I need to do now is to figure out, well, what about this other 1.6 million? So need to figure out what is the interest that I'm going to apply to this 1.6 million. So this was kind of easy because if the total loan amount would be 4.4 million, this would be very easy because I would say, oh, you got 2.4, plop it in here, but that's not the case. So what I need to do is to figure out what is my weighted average interest rate. So what I'm going to do to figure out the weighted average interest rate is I'm going to take my short-term loan and my long-term loan. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add these two up and I'm going to add up the interest amounts. So my weighted average or my average interest rate for that 2.4 million is going to be 250,000 divided by 2.4 million, or about 10.42. And I know I've kind of done this right because this 10.42 falls in between these two values right here. And it's going to be a little bit closer to the 10% just because the interest amount here was 140,000. So this is my weighted average interest rate. And this is what I'm going to use to go through over here and apply to this remaining amount in terms of the weighted average of accumulated construction expenditures. So again, stepping back for a second, if I am undergoing building construction, and if I'm undergoing building construction, whether or not I take out debt, I need to come up, because I'm self-constructing an asset, what I need to go through and do, if I have any debt costs of that construction, I need to capitalize it for financial reporting purposes. So to figure out how much do I capitalize, I compare the actual interest to the avoidable interest and I take the lesser of the two. My actual interest was 490,000. The avoidable interest is going to be the weighted average of accumulated expenditures. So of 3 points. So what I have over here is I've got this, I've spent 3.6 million. This is on a weighted average basis. So how do I figure out the interest rate to apply to this weighted average accumulated expenditure amount? Well, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the amount of the construction specific loan, or were there any loans that were construction specific? And here we have this 2 million. So I'm immediately going to use this 2 million first at 12%. However, for the remaining amount, the short-term and the long-term loan were both non-specific to the construction. So what I need to then do on this remaining amount of the weighted average accumulated expenditure of 1.6 million, how did I get 1.6 million? It's gonna be 3.6 minus 2 million equals 1.6 million. So to figure out the interest rate that I should be using on this 1.6 million, what I need to do is to figure out, well, of this other debt that's here, what's the weighted average interest rate? So to figure that out, I'm gonna take the loan amounts. I'm gonna take the interest rates related to those loans, and I'm gonna come up with a average interest rate by taking the total amount of interest divided by the total amount of the loans. And this is giving me about 10.42%. So when I multiply this through, I'm going to get 166,667. So when I add up these two amounts, I get 406,667. Your book has a slightly different answer. What they did over here is they said, oh, just go ahead and round it. So they went, and that's how you're getting to that book response. So when I look over here, the amount of the, so assuming that they completed, compute the avoidable interest. Okay, so this here is the avoidable interest. Now what they're asking us to do is to say, compute the depreciation expense for the year ended December 31st, 2021. Harris elected to depreciate the building on a straight line basis and determined that the asset has a useful life of 30 years and a salvage value of $300,000. So if I look at letter A, the total building cost was 5.2 million. And then my avoidable interest, or my interest capitalized, is going to be 406,720. So my total acquisition cost of this building is going to be roughly about 5.6 million. So my acquisition cost here is about 5.6 million. So now what I'm going to go through and do is, it's telling me that I'm using straight line. So this is going to be my acquisition cost minus my salvage value divided by my estimated useful life. This is going to be 5,606,720 minus 300,000 divided by my estimated useful life of 30 years. So my straight line depreciation expense is going to be about 176,000. So that is how we go through and solve this particular question. So I want to thank you for joining me here today on exercise 10-7, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great one.